All right, y'all. So last night we had Shakur Stevenson, the young phenom, Olympic silver medalist, former featherweight champion, versus Jamel Herring, the WBO super featherweight champion, and a bout which, was kind of a young lion versus the established lion, you know what I'm saying, the veteran, to see who was going to be able to have their way in that bout. And, young Shakur Stevenson going into the fight, a lot of detractors, a lot of people having their doubts about him, a lot of people overly critical of him, much like they are of a lot of the young, American phenoms, so to speak, or prospects, or, contenders or young champions even. And at the same time, there are a lot of people who are very high on Shakur Stevenson, myself being one of them. And I'll be honest, I also have my criticisms too, because if you're high on a fighter, then you hold them to in high regard and have high standards for them or high expectations, you should look at what they do with a critical eye. And I believe in being critical of a fighter. I don't believe in being overly critical of a fighter. And also being hypocritical in your assessments of that fighter when by comparison to how you look at other fighters or how you break down other fighters. But all that being said, going into this fight, we knew what we had in Jamel Herring, a very respected veteran champion, a guy who has had a mixed bag in terms of his performances since being a champion, but ultimately a guy who kept having successful defenses. And last time out, he went over and put on a clinic of a beating of Frampton. So, and then with Herring, we have a guy who's kind of had a mixture, in his fights. He's had some fights to where he just went out and he just looked the part, looked like he was the next big thing. And then he had some fights where at spots he kind of looked tentative and kind of looked as if, if he's still trying to figure out, his style, trying to figure out, how he wants to approach certain types of fighters and certain types of situations in fights. But ultimately, a guy who has a high ceiling and a guy who we expect to, if he is what we think he is, to be able to beat Jamel Herring as good as Herring is. And when the fight took place, Shakur Stevenson came out right away and established that he was a favorite for good reason, and that he had skills to burn, and he was going to put those skills on display. He wasn't going to let the moment be too big for him, and he went out there and performed. I gave Jamel Herring, I think, one or two rounds. I know the fifth I gave him, for some reason, I felt like I gave him another round after that, but I could be mistaken. But I definitely felt like Shakur was showing him things that were troubling him. Shakur was on the inside, he was busy, and even when they were separating, he would always hook around the guard. Shakur was stabbing him to the body with that jab. It was a thing of beauty. And I think that was the one thing that would trouble Jamel more than anything, even more than that looping hook. Was because at every time Jamel would try to jab his way in and try to, put himself in position to punch, Shakur was like, "Watch out, watch out!" Hit him with that jab to the body, and he was working that punch masterfully. But also, Shakur's hand speed was too much for him. Shakur, you could tell he was thinking in there. He wasn't just in there, just trying to get in there and just throw shots like a lot of young fighters do sometimes. They get in there and just try to display their hand speed and their volume and their angles and things like that. Everything that Shakur was doing in there, he was doing it purposefully and doing it with intentions. And he was setting up, you could tell he was setting up his shots in a way in which he had a goal of being able to basically take over the later parts of every round. You know what I'm saying? And he would make sure, and that's what I really, really like, because you don't see that all the time in young fighters. Shakur would finish every round strong. And to me, that's a hallmark of a champion. Because it's easy to go out there for some of these guys to go out there and be front runners in a round. And then in the latter part of the round, they're in defensive mode and letting the other guy potentially steal the round or get back into the round. I like that I saw last night that Shakur was finishing every round strong and that he was, and I mean for the most part, I'm not going to say every, but for the most part, he was finishing every round strong. He was trying to finish every exchange. You know what I'm saying? He wanted to be the last man getting a punch in exchanges. And ultimately, I just felt like Shakur did a lot of things great. You know, we've all heard the stories and seen footage of Shakur in the gym sparring. And I always said that, you know, eventually what we see in the gym is going to translate to the bright lights. And he's going to put on that type of display against a good fighter under the bright lights. Last night was that fight for me. And I think the other thing Shakur did for himself was he made Shakur Stevenson must-see TV after what he did last night. It was on a big stage. They had the main event in Atlanta. It was on, you know, primetime television, so to speak, a major network. Not necessarily a primetime slot, but it was major network. And it was the only big fight on. So they had the stage. And when you got the stage like that, that's when you got to go out there and perform. That's when you can't go out there and have a ho-hum, lackluster performance that hurts your stock. Shakur Stevenson did nothing but improve his stock and make people want to see him more last night. He got a great win over a good champion. And I feel like Shakur didn't just happen to get that 10th round stoppage. He was putting rounds in the bank, but also making investments early on that led to that 10th round stoppage. Because had he done what he done in the 10th round without putting in everything he did before that, the ref doesn't stop that fight. I think it was after seeing this in this round, this in that round, this in that round, and then this in the 10th, okay, let's go ahead. Enough is enough. This guy's not getting back into this fight. And sometimes in boxing, stoppages happen because a fighter is so far out of a fight that once they get in trouble, the ref's like, okay, this guy ain't winning this fight anyway. And then he's in all this trouble. Let me go ahead and wave it off. I had no issue with the stoppage. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't have had an issue had they let Herring continue because he wasn't terribly hurt. But I think that was one of those stoppages that was basically, like I said, he paved the road for that stoppage rounds earlier. And it was one of those situations where the ref said, okay, it's just been enough. Overall, it's been enough. Time to stop it. But, you know, no knock on Jamel Herring. He went out there and gave a good performance. I'm sure he'll look back at the fight and think there's some things that he could have done differently, could have done better. You know, and I'm sure, you know, his whole team probably feels that way. But at the same time, I also feel like it was a situation where he just was outgunned, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, Shakur Stevenson went out there and done what he was supposed to do. Congrats to Shakur on a good win, a great win for his young career. And I want to see more of them. That's all I got on the D-Lo 44 Boxing. Like, share, comment, subscribe. I'm out. Till next time. Peace.